Hello everyone. The last class we have discussed about various enzymes which are used to diagnose acute myocardial infarctions. And today we are going to discuss about various enzymes which are used in diagnosis of some liver diseases. The enzymes which are used to diagnose some of the liver diseases can be commonly grouped into two categories. So the first thing, enzymes whose elevation in serum reflects any damage to the hepatocytes. And the next thing, enzymes whose elevations in the serum reflects any cholestasis. Enzymes that reflect damage to the hepatocytes. The aminotransferases are a group of enzymes which serve as a sensitive indicator of a liver cell injury, and it helps in recognizing acute hepatocellular diseases like hepatitis. So these aminotransferases includes aspartate aminotransferase, that is AST, and alanine aminotransferase, that is ALT. Under aminotransferases, aspartate aminotransferase, it is found in the liver, cardiac muscle, skeletal muscle, kidneys, brain, pancreas, lungs, leukocytes and erythrocytes in decreasing order of concentration. Its normal level is found to be 0 to 41 IU per liter, whereas the ALT, that is alanine aminotransferase, is found primarily in the liver. Its normal level is found to be 0 to 45 IU per liter. These aminotransferase enzymes are normally present in the serum at very low concentrations, but if it's there any liver cell injury, the level of these aminotransferases are very high, that is due to the increased permeability of the liver cells. So the next one, the diagnostic significance of aminotransferases, the levels up to 300 unit per liter are non-specific and it may be found in any type of liver disorder. So the striking elevations, that is the aminotransferases about 1000 unit per liter, occurs almost exclusively in disorders which is associated with the extensive hepatic cell injury, like viral hepatitis, sometimes ischemic liver injury, that is due to prolonged hypotension or sometimes acute heart failure, or toxin or drug induced hepatic cell injury. In most of the cases, the ALT is higher than or it's equal to AST. Generally, an AST is to ALT ratio less than 2 is to 1 is suggestive, while a ratio about 3 is to 1 is highly suggestive in case of alcoholic liver disease. So the AST in the alcoholic liver disease is rarely less than 300 units per liter, and the ALT is often normal. A low level of ALT in the serum is due to an alcohol-induced deficiency of pyridoxal phosphate. In obstructive jaundice, the aminotransferases are usually not seen. The next thing, the enzymes that reflect cholestasis. Cholestasis is actually a condition in which the flow of bile from the liver is stopped or slowed down. So the activity of three enzymes like alkaline phosphatase, 5' nucleotidase and gamma glutamyl transpeptidase are usually elevated in case of cholestasis. Alkaline phosphatase and 5' nucleotidase are found in or near the bile canalicular membrane of hepatocytes, whereas the gamma glutamyl transpeptidase is located in the endoplasmic reticulum and in the bile duct epithelial. The normal level of serum alkaline phosphatase consists of many distinct isoenzymes found in liver, bone, placenta and less commonly in the small intestine. And apart from this, some physiological variations will be there. So in patients over age 60 can have a mildly elevated alkaline phosphatase, and the persons with the blood group O and B can have a high serum alkaline phosphatase after eating a fatty meal. It is also non-pathologically elevated in children and adolescents undergoing rapid bone growth because of bone alkaline phosphatase. It is also high in normal pregnancy due to the influx of placental alkaline phosphatase. So the next thing, the pathological variations. Elevation of liver-derived alkaline phosphatase is not totally specific for cholestasis alone, and a less than threefold elevation and can be seen in almost any type of liver diseases. Alkaline phosphatase elevations greater than 4 times normal occur primarily in patients with cholestatic liver disorders, infiltrative liver disorders such as cancer and amyloidosis. In liver diseases, the elevation of alkaline phosphatase is almost always due to the increased amount of liver isoenzyme. So the cholestasis are of two types. One is intrahepatic cholestasis and another one is extrahepatic cholestasis. So in case of intrahepatic cholestasis, the values of alkaline phosphatase are increased in drug-induced hepatitis. And in case of primary biliary sclerosis, rejection of liver transplantation, and rarely alcohol-induced steatonecrosis. And the next thing is extrahepatic cholestasis. Here, very high values are found in case of obstructive jaundice due to cancer, and sometimes also due to the common duct stone, sclerosing cholangitis, or bile duct stricture. So the level of serum alkaline phosphatase elevation is not helpful in distinguishing between the extrahepatic and intrahepatic cholestasis. The isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase like hepatic isoenzyme, bone isoenzyme, placental isoenzyme, intestinal isoenzyme, and Regan isoenzymes are there. So the first thing, the hepatic isoenzyme travels fastest towards the anode in their electrophoresis, and it occupies the same position as the alpha 2 globulin. Its level rises in case of extrahepatic biliary obstruction. And the next one is the bone isoenzyme. Its level increases due to the osteoblastic activity, and it is normally elevated in case of actively growing children. And the next one is the placental isoenzyme. It is raised during last 6 weeks of pregnancy. And the next one is the intestinal isoenzyme. It also rises after a fatty meal. It may also increase during various gastrointestinal disorders. Apart from these isoenzymes, there are two more isoenzymes are there. Regan isoenzyme. It is present in the plasma of about 15% of patients with a carcinoma of lung, liver, and or gut. It is also seen in chronic smokers. It structurally resembles placental alkaline phosphatase. And the next one is NAGO isoenzyme. It is a variant of Regan isoenzyme. It is detected in metastatic carcinoma of pleural surfaces and adenocarcinoma of pancreas and bile duct. Another one important enzyme, alpha glutamyl transferase. It is involved in amino acid transport across the membranes, and it is found mainly in the biliary ducts of the liver, kidney, and pancreas. Enzyme activity is induced by a number of drugs, and in particularly alcohol consumption. So the glutamyl transferase increased in liver diseases, especially in case of obstructive jaundice. And these glutamyl transferase levels are used as a marker of alcohol-induced liver disease and in liver cancer. 5' nucleotidase, it is moderately increased in case of hepatitis and highly elevated in the case of biliary obstruction. Unlike the alkaline phosphatase, the level is unrelated to the osteoblastic activity and is thus unaffected by the bone disease. The enzyme hydrolyzes 5' nucleotides to 5' nucleosides to an optimum pH of about 7.5. So this graph shows the various serum enzymes in the liver diseases. In viral hepatitis, there is rapid rise in transaminases in serum occurs even before bilirubin rises. So this one shows various enzymes used in gastrointestinal tract diseases, including acute pancreatitis. So the first thing, amylase. Its serum activity less than 1000 units is seen within 24 hours in acute pancreatitis. The values are diagnostic. A raised serum activity is also seen in persons with a perforated peptic ulcer and intestinal obstruction. And another one important enzyme, lipase. Its level as high as 2800 units per liter are seen in acute pancreatitis. It is also reported high in perforated duodenal and peptic ulcers and intestinal obstruction. So with this, I think you have got an idea about various enzymes used in diagnosis of various diseases. And this table clearly shows various enzymes which are used to diagnose some other diseases. And I think with this, you have got an idea about clinical enzymology. That is the enzymes which are used to diagnose some clinical manifestations. I will meet you in some other presentation. Thank you.